Hi, I just discovered an app that you can use to stream high quality video to Facebook, to YouTube, to Twitch, to Telegram, even custom RTMP server using just your mobile device. You don't need any system at all. You don't need any camera setup at all. All you need is just your mobile phone, and you can stream up to 4K video quality to all the platforms I just mentioned. And the name of the mobile app is called OmniStream. This application is fully backed, and one of the notable features about the OmniStream application is the Wi-Fi plus cellular bundle features. And what does this mean? When you connect the Wi-Fi to your phone and your phone cellular data is also on as well, the OmniStream application helps to bundle the two of them together, thereby giving you a good network speed. We're also going to be exploring that and other features during the course of this video. Also made a couple of other videos about the OmniStream application, which I would strongly recommend you check them out also, and how you can properly sign up and create an account for yourself. I've also done a video on that as well. I will leave the link in the description of this particular video. So let's dive in. Go ahead and open the OmniStream application, and you're going to see this interface just like the one you can see on my screen right now. Now at the top, you're going to see 3MB. Click on that, and this is where you set your video bitrate. See, it has 1, 2, 3, up to 16, 12, and 8 as well. So you could choose any number, not just any number. Before you choose your video bitrate, let me also show you how to test your internet speed, okay? How to get your internet supported bitrate. And for you to be able to do this, click on the 3-dot line and you see speed test. Go over to speed test, and you can see the speed text in progress. We're just going to allow the mobile app to analyze our network so this will give us the bitrate, our internet support. Once the OmniStream has finished analyzing our network, see, just like the one you see right here on the screen, it said no broadcast issues have been found. If there's any issue found, it's also going to list that for you. Don't be scared if you get issues like this, just like the one you see right there on the screen where it says some issues were found. It will also give you a guide on how you can be able to fix it. See, some issues we have found. Total bitrate is 4.67. Requested bitrate is 3. On the Wi-Fi, you see warning, no bandwidth on carrier. Now, measured bitrate is 1.7. It said the Wi-Fi, you shouldn't use it alone. Total bitrate is 5.4 and requested bitrate is 3. Now, you also see the Wi-Fi decent connection. Measured bitrate is 2.47 and also my phone cellular data, good connection, the measured bitrate also is 2.9. Once you've seen the video bitrate your network support, please make sure you stay within that range, or rather you could lower the number, okay, so that you won't have any issue at all. If your video bitrate support 5, please you could reduce it to either 2 or 3, but don't increase it to 8 or 12, okay, because your internet does not support higher video bitrate. But if you do, you could play around with the number also, but just make sure you stay within that range. Remember, during the course of this video, I made mention of the bundling features, which is one of the things I love most about the OmniStream mobile app, okay? Now, how do you set that? If you take a look at the bottom left here, you're going to see 2 out of 2. That is because it's the Wi-Fi connected to my phone, and my phone cellular data is also on as well. The OmniStream app have bundled the two networks together. Now, how do you set yours? Click on that 3-dot line here, and then go over to settings, okay? Over to settings here, and you're going to see a different interface again. From here, just scroll down till you see transport, okay? On the transport, you see network interface. Click on the network interface and you're going to see, choose a network interface. Make sure it's not on cellular, and also make sure it's not on Wi-Fi. Put it on Wi-Fi plus cellular, okay? So that to be able to bond the two of them together, bond the Wi-Fi connected and also your phone cellular, make sure it's on as well, just like my, as you can see here on the screen, just like my, as you can see here, mobile data is on here, and that is why the two of them can be easily bonded together. Okay, so your question, do you need to have active data on your phone cellular? Yes, very, very important. You need to have active data on your phone cellular so that you can use that to bond with the Wi-Fi connected to your phone. Okay, so if there's no active data on your phone, it will also display that for you as well. So you need to have active data on your phone cellular for you to be able to bond it with the Wi-Fi connected to your phone, all right? And this is how to set it from here. Now let's go back, also show you how to connect your different social media and also set your resolution. Now, if you take a look at the top right here, you're going to see the camera icon there. Okay, click on it. And from here, you see the camera source, the resolution by the side, and also the codec type. Now click on the camera source. And from here, you could use your internal back or your internal front, depending on the camera you want to use, if you want to use your front camera or your back camera. If you also take a look there, you see the Omni Capture. which is the one I've also made a video on. You could use this to connect a custom capture card or video grabber to your mobile device and turn your phone into HDMI transmitter. Okay, now by the side of it, click on it, you're going to see the resolution. Now from here, you have 4K with different 4K resolution with different frame rate. Now to your question, can I stream on 4K? Yes, you can, if your phone support 4K and also you have a strong internet connection. Okay, if you have a strong internet connection and your phone support 4K, go ahead and choose that. But if you don't, please do not attempt to stream 4K. Now you also have different frame rate as well. You have the 1920 by 1080 with 30 FPS, 50, 60, different resolution here. You have the 480 and also the 576 as well. Okay, so you could choose any of the resolution that your phone or your mobile device support. Okay, now by the side of it, you see the codec type here. You have the HEVC, which is the high efficient video coding, and also the MPEG-4. You could select any of them that you want to make use of. If you want to use the high efficient video coding or you want to use the MPEG, so I usually make use of the MPEG, but you could choose any of them that you want to make use of, okay, based on your connections. Okay, now I'm just going to go ahead and choose the MPEG here. And then how do you bring in your lower third and also set your mic? If you take a look at the bottom screen there, you see the mic icon. Click on the mic icon. From here you see the list of custom mic that are plugged in to your mobile device. If you don't have any custom mic plugged into your mobile device, you won't see it listed here, but if you do, you also be able to see that as a list of mic that it can connect to. How do you zoom in or out of your shots? Now click on this plus icon down here with the circle here, click on it, and from here you could zoom your shot in and out. How do you connect your social media account? Now if you click on this arrow sign there at the top with this green button on it beside the three dot line, click on that. From here you will see all the platform. You have the Facebook, you have the YouTube, you have Twitch, Telegram is also there as well. You have the custom RTMP to do your custom RTMP live stream. You also have the SRT listener, which I've also made a video on. If you want to connect to your Facebook account, just go ahead and click on Facebook and it's going to load. Okay, just give it a moment, it's going to load, currently loading, and once that is done, connect it to your Facebook account and you could see it right here on the screen. This is my Facebook, and when you click on share to, you could see list of pages. If I don't want to share it on my timeline, it also provided me with pages I manage on Facebook that I could also share the live broadcast on, and also Facebook group as well are included. So if I want to share to Facebook group, I can from the mobile app. If I want the broadcast to be done on the Facebook page or my timeline, whichever one, I have the options to pick from here on the screen. So I'm just going to pick my page. Now for the YouTube as well, click on YouTube, just give it a moment for it to load. Currently connecting to our YouTube account. Now select an email that is linked to your YouTube channel. Okay, I have a list of channels here, just going to pick this one, that is the Portechi one. Okay, just give it a moment for it to load, and that will connect our YouTube channel. Okay, you can see right there on the screen the YouTube is connected already. And from the category here, you see the list of category. You can also select video blogging, and then if you want it to be on public, I want everything to be unlisted. Okay, once you're done, go ahead and put in your title. Over to Facebook as well, write your title, test again, test, click on done, then submit. On the custom RTMP, click on it and you could copy your custom RTMP URL and also the stream key and the RTMP key as well, paste it here. Once you're done, click on submit. Okay, then once everything is fully set up, let's just go ahead and close this. How do you bring in your lower third, your title, your logo, just like the one you could see right there on the screen by the top right there. Now you see the plus icon there, click on it, and from here you could see the logo, lower third, start soon, full size, and spot. You want to bring in your logo, click on logo here, and now you could upload your logo or you could also get the link from the web. Now click on upload. Tell me if I want it small, medium, or large. I want this logo to be in small size. Which position do I want the logo to be on? So they've given you all these options. If I want it to be on the left, if I want it to be on the right. So I want it to be at the top right there. Click on submit once you've selected your position. Click the plus icon there at the top. If you want to edit your logo, you see the edit icon at the top of the logo. Click on it. From here, you could update the logo, delete the logo, and at the same time, you could also update the position or change the width of the logo. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and close that. If you want to bring in your lower third, click on it again, this plus here, and then go over to lower third. Now on the lower third, add in your main title. I'm just going to write Paul here. On that one, I'm just going to write Techie as well. Once you're done, click on here and then submit. And they've given us list of lower third I could select from. Okay, don't forget that more updates are being done on the app and more features will be added soon as well. Now click on this one here, or this one, or this one, depending on whichever one you want to use. And once you selected your lower third, go ahead and click on submit. Just going to go ahead and cancel this because I don't want to bring in lower third on my broadcast. Now once you're done with all the settings, the next thing you're going to do is to click on this live button at the center of the screen. That smaller screen there will see what has been sent out to Facebook and also to YouTube as well. Okay. Now, if you click on this thing that looks like right here, okay, beside that, I'm just going to mark, put an R. If you click on this thing that looks like a pie chart at the top there, just this here, when you click on it, when you click on that, you see the ratio that is coming in from your phone cellular and also from the Wi-Fi. Remember, the two have been bonded together. So you see the percentage that is coming in from here and also the percentage that is also coming in from the Wi-Fi or your phone cellular. Okay, have like a clear picture what ratio is coming in from your phone cellular and what ratio is coming in from the Wi-Fi, and that is what this chart gives you. When you click on this icon there, you see list of social media that is being streamed on and how many people are connecting, or rather how many people are watching. We're using the back camera before, but I just changed it to front camera and you could see what it looks like. You could see what it looks like right there on the screen. This is how it looks there. So I move my head, the whole thing is moving. Move this around, you could see the fan blowing on my back there, and it's not lagging at all. Just very smooth, as you can see there. It's very smooth, and the picture quality is also nice as well. See it there on the screen. Over to YouTube. Now over to YouTube, we see how it looks like. See, we're currently live. This is live here. We see one watching now. You see how it looks like, how clean it looks. See here, how clean it looks. And we're currently live on YouTube. This is my front camera, not my back camera. I'm currently using the front camera. I will just raise this up a bit. You could see me very well. See? Currently what it looks like. And what this is what we're streaming on. We're not even streaming on full HD. We are streaming on 720, 30 FPS. You could see. We are not even doing a 4K live stream, just 720, and you can see how clean it is. So if you want to enjoy a smooth live stream, don't also forget to use a strong internet, okay?